Small changes at a local national monument are causing a big uproar. Today, crews took down the letters for the Jefferson Davis Memorial Park at Fort Monroe.
We posted this story earlier on Wavy.com, and we were met with hundreds of comments. Our Kara Dixon spoke with officials at Fort Monroe who say they want the history that happened there to open up a dialogue.
Yeah, they do, Tom and Anita, especially with a huge anniversary coming up at the end of the month. But the fort says while the letters are coming down, they're not erasing history and are just putting some context to the park. And they hope it will start a much-needed conversation. These stones of Fort Monroe have stood on this land longer than the existence of most of our nation.
Fort Monroe is an amazing place where we are able to initiate conversations that our country has never had before.
A long and deep-rooted history. That's why Glenn Oder with the Fort Monroe Authority sees these letters coming down here at the Jefferson Davis Memorial Park as an opportunity to engage.
Today is the day where we conclude a very long process that started in April.
That's when Governor Ralph Northam wrote the authority asking them to remove this arch in anticipation of the 400th commemoration of the first enslaved Africans brought here. After research, public meetings, and comments, they found that this arch, built in the 1950s in honor of the Confederate president jailed here after the Civil War, couldn't be taken down. It's built into the foundation. So,
we're going to remove the letters from the arch. So it's a bit of a compromise.
The letters will go into the Casemate Museum, which operates within the fort's walls, and will be told alongside the already existing Jefferson Davis exhibit.
This is allowing us an opportunity to tell history the way it was intended to be told, in terms of when was the arch installed, why was it installed, what did it mean. And then we'll also let people interpret for themselves what does the arch mean for them.
So history isn't going away once these letters come down. They're hoping, though, that all the passion surrounding this and the upcoming commemoration does spark conversations our country needs to have to move forward as one.
The mission of Fort Monroe is to continue to bring people together so that we can have these conversations in an open and safe environment.
Now, Oder says this is a reversible effect. That means if someone in the future wants to put these lettering back up, they can. Now, there are no plans to rename the park, but there will be interpretive signs at the location explaining what it was and why it was put up. I'm Kara Dixon, 10 on your side.